matter is sub judice, but I don't expect Rahul Gandhi to know anything about rules of sub judice. Actually, it borders on contempt. The Supreme Court has been seized of this matter on 4 occasions, and he should know that the matter is pending adjudication by the highest court of this land. But, you know, this is in keeping with, I don't want to say much about Rahul Gandhi and not get personal. Obviously, he's been stung by the impact of demonetization, and he's getting desperate now. His attack, personal attacks on the Prime Minister are increasing. They're all unfounded and unwarranted. And I hope that appropriate action is taken against him, not only in the form of defamation, but also for contempt of court.
So, get a better understanding of what you're saying, is there a possibility here also that the Supreme Court itself takes cognizance of what Rahul Gandhi has said today at a public platform?
Well, the Supreme Court, it all depends. The Supreme Court can take suo motu action and do it. The whole chapter, people are getting desperate and extremely personal. And irresponsible. I must say that the allegations against Chief Justice Kehar were extremely unfortunate. I mean, they should not have been done, especially after, and I'm referring to what Prashant Bhushan did in court. The judge was, honorable judge was seized of the matter for 4 hearings, and it was never raised at all. At the end of these 4 hearings, when it became obvious that the judges were going to oppose Mr. Bhushan's petition, that's when it happened. Now, both Mr. Bhushan and Mr. Rahul Gandhi are acting grossly irresponsibly.
Do you believe that the BJP should not take this lying down, and the BJP should take this, seek legal recourse, because this is in front of a huge gathering in Mehsana in Gujarat that Rahul Gandhi has chosen to read out the very same details which Prashant Bhushan was making an argument for in the Supreme Court when these observations came forth, Mr. Jethmalani?
You know, I don't think anybody takes Rahul Gandhi seriously. I don't think we should. His whole history, political career is one of abject defeat. So why would one want to take him seriously and do it? The best way to answer Rahul Gandhi's allegations is in a court of law where it is pending, A, and B, and then put an end to it all, and then sue him for defamation after the court decides this whole issue once and for all. Then take him on. And secondly, of course, give him a resounding defeat at the polls.
Because it now becomes, because the Honorable Supreme Court also observed the same, that it becomes very easy to cast aspersions just on the basis of certain notings. Tomorrow, other people will say, I have these notings. And they'll say, this was in 2013, this was in 2012. Unless there is concrete proof, should people be allowed this liberty? And somebody like the Congress Vice President doing this allows anybody and everybody to cast aspersions on anybody and everybody.
Yes, Siddha, I mean, if what you're saying is that he's irresponsible, the Supreme Court will deal with it appropriately in its orders once it's seized of the matter. So I don't think we should go beyond that right now and ask political parties to jump into the fray. I think political parties should recognize the sources from which these allegations emanate, that is politically motivated and desperate, and not give that person more importance than is due.
Yes.
I think the whole country recognizes that Rahul Gandhi is the chief brat of the nation. And I think that's how he should be treated.
Mahesh Jethmalani, appreciate you joining us. Thank you so much for joining us. We're getting more.